How to take the derivative of a regular expression. It sounds like we're combining things that don't even make sense together, like ghosts and fruit. But sometimes you get lucky, and no one notices. Using derivatives of a regular expression, we can implement an algorithm to do regex matching. This algorithm is very simple, functional, and easily extendable with our own operators. It also plays well with other functional concepts such as memoization, laziness, and fixed points. It can also be extended to handle matching of context-free grammars and trees. In 1964, Brzozowski published the first paper about derivatives of regular expressions. In this video, I'm going to show you how we match the string with a regular expression using only two simple functions, and I'm going to use Pacman to do it. First, let's do a quick review of regular expressions, just to make sure that we're on the same page. Here we see an expression that matches a string that starts with an A, which is followed by any number of A's or B's. The string AB will match the regex, and we're going to indicate this using an editable blue ghost from Pacman. The string A, A, B, 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 A. Was that the right number of B's? Who knows? But it also matches the regex since it starts with an A and is followed by any number of A's and B's. Next, the string AC does not match the regex since that regex does not match any C's and our regex does not do any like substring matching. We indicate that the string does not match with a red ghost from Pacman that is chasing us. Finally, the string BA also does not match the regex since it starts with a B and we need our strings to start with an A. Cool, now the recap is done and we can move on to the algorithm. Before delving into the details, let's get an overview of how this algorithm works. To explain, I've devised a weird game of Pacman where you only get to eat the ghosts if you eat the fruit in a sequence that matches the regex. Sounds weird, but bear with me. So our Pacman represents the regex ABA star, and it has the following string of fruit to eat: an apple, then a banana, and then an apple. When we start, the ghost is chasing us, since we haven't eaten fruit that matches our regex. So what we do, we eat an apple. Now the regular expression that we have left to match is BA star. But the ghost is still chasing us since we've not eaten fruit that matched our original regex. So we eat a banana. Now the regular expression that we have left to match is A star. Technically, the apple and banana already match the regular expression A, B, A star. So the ghost becomes edible and starts running away. But we can still eat another apple. And the regular expression that is left to match is still A star, and the ghost is still running away. Let's dissect what is happening here. The Pacman eating a fruit represents the derivative function. This means the derivative of ABA star with respect to A is BA star. The derivative function takes a regular expression and a character, and returns the regular expression that is left to match. The regular expression that is left to match after eating the apple is BA star. This also means the derivative of BA star with respect to B is A star. There is one more function at work here, the function that checks whether the ghost is chasing the Pacman or the Pacman is chasing the ghost. When the regular expression has been matched, the Pacman should start chasing the ghost. This function is called the nullable function. It simply checks whether the regex that is left to match matches the empty string. It can do that because if the regex that is left to match matches the empty string, then the fruit that has been eaten must have already been enough to satisfy the regex. That means we only need two functions to write the derivative matching algorithm: the derivative function and the nullable function. When we have these, we can simply loop over the input string, eat all the fruit, and check that the resulting Pacman matches the empty string. Here we have two implementations. one in Go for the imperative programmers, and one in Haskell for the functional programmers. These two functions are equivalent and just written in different styles of programming. In the Haskell code, the fold L or fold left simply does the work of the for loop for you. And also in Haskell, we don't need commas to pass parameters to functions. Since function application is the most common operation in a functional programming language, we simply use space to delimit parameters. Now let's dive deeper into how to implement the nullable and derivative functions. To do this, we first have to find the basic operators that are available in our regex. We can think of a regex as describing a set of strings. This means the empty set represents matching no strings, whereas the empty string represents a singleton set that only matches the empty string. The character A is the same. It also represents a singleton set that only matches the character A. We can then combine these regexes using operators like OR, concatenation, and cleany star, where R and S represents two different regular expressions. Now that we've defined our regex data type, we can look at how to implement our two functions that use this data type as input. We can start with the nullable function. Let's look at some examples to try to figure out which of these regexes match the empty string to get some insight into how this function is implemented. We look at the regex A star. This matches the empty string since zero or more includes zero. We look at A star or B. Well, this also matches the empty string since the left side of the OR matches the empty string. AB does not match the empty string, since it only matches the string AB. AB star also doesn't match the empty string, since AB star requires at least an A to start with. A or B also does not match the empty string, since neither the left or the right side of the OR matches the empty string. I hope these examples give you some insight into how the nullable function will be defined. Here is the implementation of the nullable function. The left side are values that are passed into the function, and the right side is the implementation of the function in that case. The empty set doesn't match the empty string, since it doesn't match any string. The empty string matches only the empty string. The character A does not match the empty string. But now when we get to the logical OR, we have to check both sides whether they match the empty string. If we concatenate two regular expressions, well, the only way they can match the empty string is if they both match the empty string. And then finally, if we have zero or more of something, then that includes zero, which also matches the empty string. Now let's run an example through our function. So given the regular expression B or A star, our top operator is the OR. So this says we have to check the nullability of the left and the right side. We check to see that the character B on the left side is not nullable. Then we check and see that the zero or more expression on the right side is nullable. Now we get back false and true, and we have to OR them to get true. So the expression B or A star is nullable. And that makes sense, since it will match the empty string. Great. Now we can move on to the derivative function. Before we look at the implementation of the function, let's look at some examples of what the derivative is. Here we're going to take the derivative of a few regular expressions, all with respect to the character A. The regular expression that is left to match after A star has eaten an apple is still A star. The derivative of AB star with respect to A is B star, since we've already matched the prefix A. The derivative of A or B concatenated with B with respect to A is B. The derivative of B or A star B with respect to A is A star B. The left me didn't, B didn't match, so we could throw it away, and the A was consumed by the zero more A's on the right. Next we have AB star. This one's slightly tricky. After it has eaten an apple, the regular expression that is left to match is B AB star. Since we've only matched the A, we're expecting to see at least one B. I hope these examples give you some intuition for how the derivative function will be defined. Now we need to define the derivative function that takes a regex, matches a single character, and returns the regex that is left to match. Here we define the derivative function with respect to the character A. The derivative of the empty set is always the empty set. Like, there's no way of recovering, since the empty set doesn't match anything. The derivative of the empty string with respect to any character is the empty set. It wasn't expecting to match any character. It will only match the empty string. Derivative of a single character with respect to a similar character, in this case the apple, is the empty string, since after it has matched itself, all that is left to match is the empty string. The derivative of another character with respect to a different character that is not equal, in this case the banana, is the empty set, since we have not matched the appropriate character. The derivative of an OR expression is the OR of the derivatives. It simply pushes the problem down to its children. The derivative of the concat expression has to consider whether it can skip over the first expression or not. And it can only skip over the first expression if the first expression matches the empty string, like is nullable. So the first thing we have to do, we have to check this. Let's think about the case where it cannot skip over the first expression. Well, then, like where the expression R is not nullable. Well, then the derivative is just the derivative of the first expression concatenated with the second expression S. If we can skip over, we have to consider an alternative that is only the derivative of the second expression. We can then OR these two alternatives of skipping over R and not skipping over R and return them as a result. Finally, we have the star operator. It matches an expression zero or more times. And since we're being passed a character, this is not the zero case. So we have to consider the one or more case. This means we have to take the derivative of the expression inside the star and concatenate it again with the zero or more expression. And that's the derivative function. We can combine the nullable function with this derivative function to create the regular expression matching function that we showed earlier. The concatenation and zero or more rules can take a while to fully grasp, so let's do some examples. Let's take the derivative of AB star with respect to A. It is a zero or more expression, so we look to the zero or more rule. We see that this requires taking the derivative of the expression inside the star, which is the concatenation of A and B, so we look to the concatenation rule. We see that we have to check the nullability of R, but this is the character A, and it is not nullable, so we can't skip over it. Cannot skip over it. So we take the derivative of A with respect to A, which is the empty string. We concatenate it back with our right side of the expression S, which is B, and we end up getting a B. Now we can recurse back to the zero or more. Remember, we took the derivative of AB with respect to A and got back a B. Now we can concatenate that back with AB star again, and we get back B AB star. I'll leave you with one final example, and this is kind of an exercise because of the amount of detail I'm going to skip over. Let's take the derivative of A star BA with respect to B. A star is concatenated with BA, so we take a look at the concatenation rule. We check whether the left side A star is nullable, which it is. That means we can skip over it. But that also means we have to create two alternatives of these derivatives. The left side ends up not matching since A star doesn't match B. And luckily we have an alternative, the right side, which is the BA. And the derivative of BA with respect to B is A. So we end up with just an A. And I've skipped over lots of detail here. Please go check my work and walk through the function yourself. I hope you now understand why combining fruits and ghosts makes sense. And also how to implement a regular expression matcher using the derivative algorithm. What we have covered here is the basic algorithm, and it already works, but there are a lot of ways to make this algorithm even better with very small tweaks. We kind of cheated and glossed over simplification rules in this video, using them without explaining them, which will become especially clear if you walk through the exercise. We also haven't talked about how you can use memoization to lazily build an efficient automaton. And we can also easily extend the algorithm to include new operators like not, interleave, and even support context-free grammars. We will discuss some of these topics in the next video. I hope I've made the derivative algorithm easy to understand. If you liked the video and you have too much time, I would love to see your implementation in a programming language of your choice. Please send me a link in the comments. Thank you so much for watching.